Yeah. And keep me busy going back and forth. Well. Welcome, welcome. And we have people joining us virtually and those who have come here to be together today. We want to thank you and welcome you. And if you're newer to us, know that we welcome you warmly and we're glad you're here with us. So let us begin, as we always do, with a little meditation that brings us fully into the room and grounds us. So I'm going to invite you to close your eyes and begin to relax. Let's take a couple deep breaths together. Breathing in and out. And on those out breaths, just feel the tension leave your body. One more in and out. And now bring your attention from your mind and just drop that down into your heart. And maybe put your hand on your heart to keep your awareness right in that heart center. We are reminded in this moment that we are pure spirit, one with the essence of pure love. So in these moments together, we open our minds and hearts to deep, deep awareness. Divine mind, creative intelligence, this field of unlimited possibility. And we see in this spaciousness, this awareness, so vividly our beautiful Mother Earth, healed of all her wounds. Clean air, clean water, and clean soil. Thriving forests and plants. All creatures healthy and safe. With great, great reverence for our planet, the planet that supports us and all life, we say thank you. And we commit to being good stewards of our Mother Earth and all of her resources. She writes, "We are living in a time of tremendous transformation from a species arrogant enough to think it's on its own to a species that remembers where it comes from. When a critical mass remembers, allowing the love of the Father, Mother, God to heal us of our painful illusions of separation, we will be redeemed and our children will be secure. So let us listen for the many ways that the Spirit of Love speaks with us and beckons us and guides us home. So we are going to stand and sing our first fellowship song together. If you would, turn to page 1. And we'll sing The Essence of Our Spirit.
Thank you. though I'll never hear you play. This old instrument has found me after being tucked away. Like forgotten stories you never passed on, and your children's children stop singing the songs. Tonight will you keep me company as I listen for your melody and meet me in the space between the history. If I could reach you through these screens, I'd like to know the answer to so many things. Did you sing about the cherry blossom trees? And did you have Alice's fingertips like me? Tonight will you keep me company as I listen for your melody and carry me in the between the history and me? Did you strum along at the end of the day? And did your tired eyes ever cry when you played? And was your smile the same as mine? And did your husband think it was all
give us all an opportunity to think about those ties that we have with all those who have come before us and all of what they have contributed to who we are. So thank you. Thanks so much. So this is the time in our service when we pause and remember to fill ourselves with gratitude for all of the blessings and gifts in our lives. We know at the fellowship that abundance is the flow of divine energy. And A Course in Miracles teaches us that giving and receiving are one in truth, the same thing. Each of us benefits, and our community as a whole thrives because of your generosity. And so we thank you so much that you make your donation now. With us physically here, with us in spirit, and to us. It's her birthday today. So we're going to play Julie. Together. I'm really looking forward to filling this room with inspiration. Okay. Remember that participation is totally up to everybody individually, but I'm kind of hoping that you might consider helping me out. So, but I thought I'd first start with just a centering. So if you'll join me a minute in finding our in-breath. Let's just find some refuge in our in-breath. Let us surrender completely to our in-breath, allowing all restlessness and distraction to completely disappear. Let your body and your heart relax and find a very comfortable position so you can find your divine self. And as you draw your in-breath into your center, imagine you are seeking downward through the soles of your feet to connect deeper still with your earth soul. Let your in-breath draw all the love and comfort your earth soul has to give you, the love that only our Mother Earth can give to us. And allow that connection to begin to flow upward, all the way to the top of your crown. Open your crown further still, wider still. Feel that beautiful connection you have to your heavenly soul. As you continue to draw in love and comfort from your earth soul, may you also now be filled with the clear, bright light of your heavenly soul. And as your breath leaves you, help spread that love and comfort out into the room to share with all of us that are gathered here today. Feel it dance and move around us, spreading further, and let's spread it even further out into the world. Let's feel the absolute joy that is found in this connection. Feel the ease of creating this connection, knowing it is always available to all of us. So simple, and yet so complete. Thank you. So now that we're rested and feeling joyful, let us begin creating some inspiration together in this moment. And because we're meeting in person, I thought it would be really fun if we could have more of an interactive adventure today. So, I wanted to share with everybody inspiration I've been finding over this period of time. Of course, we're always going to talk about the time before and the time after, right? But I don't know about you, but during the lockdown, I really had to work hard to stay connected to my faith, to my hope, to peace. And so I just kept finding things that people said and shared with me. People would send me different readings. I'd find them on Facebook or different places, and I'd think, oh, that is so wonderful. I need to keep that. I need to read that again. Over and again. Every day, you know, inspiration exists all around us, and it really is just quietly waiting for us to awaken and deep down in our souls. And
it would be really wonderful if you have one of your own, or even if you'd like to come join me. I have lots of them I brought today, if you'd like to read one, because I thought it might even be more fun after I read one or two, if maybe you would just share with me how you felt when you heard those words. What kind of inspiration did it create inside of you? So I'm going to start. You are the light. Never let anyone or any person or any force dampen, dim, or diminish your light. Study the path of others to make your way easier and more abundant. Learn, lean toward the whispers of your own heart. Discover the universal truth and follow what dictates. Release the need to hate, to harbor division, and the enticement of revenge. Release all bitterness. Hold only love, only peace in your heart, knowing the battle of good to overcome evil is already won. Choose confrontation wisely, but when it is your time, don't be afraid to speak up, and speak out against injustice. And if you follow your truth down the road to peace and affirmation of love, if you shine like the beacon you truly are for all to see, then the poetry of all the great dreamers and philosophers is yours to manifest in a nation, a world community, and a beloved community that is finally at peace with itself. Those wonderful words came from John Lewis. And I'm going to continue. How many years of beauty do I have left? How many more do you want? Here's 34. Here's 50, here's 63, and now you're 80. And your beauty rises in ways your cells cannot even begin to imagine. And your wild bones grow luminous and ripe, having carried the weight of a very passionate life. When your hair is aflame with winter, and you have decades of learning and leaving and loving, so right into the corners of your eyes, and your children come home to find their own history in your face. When you know what it feels like to fail ferociously, and you have gained the capacity to rise and rise and rise again. When you can make your tea on a quiet and ridiculously lonely afternoon and still have a song in your heart. Owl wings beating beneath the cotton of your sweater, because your beauty began there, beneath the sweater and the skin, remember? This is where I will take you, into my arms and coo, you brave and glorious thing. You've come so far, I see you, and your beauty is breathtaking. I'd like to go dedicate that to Rose today.
I don't have titles, and
okay. I don't even have authors always, because sometimes they just show up as unknown, but I'd be happy to pull them out and leave them with you if you'd like, because I have them at home.
That is a beautiful reminder.
It is.
Isn't it?
Beautiful.
Well, I have another one that as I keep going, I'm just going to keep going, oh, this one's even better.
Oh, no. That's good.
I am not old. I am not old. I am rare. I am the standing ovation at the end of the play. I'm the hours connected into dots, into good sense. I am the fullness of existing. You may think I'm waiting to die, but actually, I'm waiting to be found. I'm a treasure, and I am a map. And these wrinkles are imprints of my journey. Just ask me anything. That one was written by Samantha Reynolds. Listen, this world is a lunatic sphere. Don't always agree it's real. Even with my feet upon it and the postman knowing my address, I don't really live here. If you are lost, if nothing makes sense anymore, if all your reference points have collapsed, if the old life is crumbling around you, if the mind is foggy, tired, and busy, if the organism is exhausted and longs to rest. Remember to celebrate, to trust, for this is a rite of passage, not an error. You are healing in your own original way. Connect with the ground right now. Breathe in, breathe out. Make room for the visitors. The sorrow, the doubt, the fear, even anger. In ancient emptiness, they just want to be felt. They just want to pass through. You are a vessel, not a separate self. You are a sky, certainly not the passing weather. In old life, that's fine. Maybe they won't understand, but trust anyway. Celebrate and connect with the ground. Jeff Brown. So, how's it feeling? Is it having the same effect that it does on me every time I read these things to myself? It's way more fun to share them. And of course, what would be inspiration without wooing? So I only chose one short one. The moon's kiss can only come through an open window. So let us always remember to keep that window open so we can feel that moon's kiss. When you come to the edge of all the light, and you know you must take a step into the darkness of the unknown, believe that one of two things are going to happen. Either there will be something solid for you to stand on, or you are going to be taught how to fly. That's always been a thing, but I have that hanging on my pole. Because every once in a while, I need to remember that myself. And that was Patrick Overton. Don't be concerned that your path is not like that of the others. It takes courage to be yourself and not to live in reaction to the likes and dislikes of others. Be courageous and follow your heart. You need to walk your own unique path in order to honor yourself and fulfill your own spiritual purpose. That's Paul for me. I met him through fellowship. If you want to be happier, feel better, and do more in life, just turn your back on reality and inflate your own ego. A new study reveals that an unrealistic, positive attitude and unfounded optimism, along with some denial of reality, will help you accomplish great things in this life. In other words, you don't need a firm grip on reality to be successful and happy. Words to live by, truly. Rule number one, there are no rules. Rule number two, what works today very well may not work tomorrow. Rule number three, always listen with your heart. It speaks with the voice of God. Rule number four, treat yourself as you would your best friend, with love and respect. Rule number five, it's not what you do, it's how you live. Rule number six, it's not how often you meditate, it's whether you live your life as a meditation. Rule number seven, it's not what you shed, it's what you embrace. Rule number eight, it's not how hard you push, it's how fully you surrender. Rule number nine, it's not about being perfect, it's about allowing yourself to be human. Rule number 10, there are no rules. And that's also unknown, I don't know where that came from.
That was wonderful.
And here's when I actually wrote myself, I thought I should share some of that sometimes so it didn't sound like I was holding this feeling. When we learn to love ourselves simply for who we are, and not for what we wish we could be. It is in this quiet moment that we will always realize we are more than we could have wished for. We are beautiful when we let our friends have their space, when we believe, when we laugh, or are moved to tears, when we just let it roll off our backs, when we talk about our dreams, when we help a turtle across the road, when we try to do the right thing, even when it comes out wrong, and even more importantly, when we take time to love. Again, another unknown. The important thing is this, to remember at any given moment to give up what you are now for what you can become. That's Charles DeVos. I do not think it is naive to think that it is the tiny, particular acts of love and joy which are going to swing the balance. That's Madeline LaAngel. I'm probably not saying all their names right, but you guys don't know anyway, so it's all good, right? I am a master of the English language, just as good as you think I have. We must never stop believing that the beautiful things that can happen, even in times of chaos. Open your eyes. You are not made of the words that hurt you, or the numbers on the scale, or the expectations you feel you will never meet. You are made up of nothing more than you. Simply, beautifully, wonderfully, uniquely you. You are a lovely and complex soul, a fascinating combination of thoughts, ideas, feelings, emotions. No other is as beautiful as you are. Absolutely beautiful. Don't forget to love yourself. Again, I know. But then I found this beautiful quote written by Ralph Waldo Emerson, and I thought, isn't this amazing, as we were talking about past lives, about how so many of the people in our past have already had these thoughts and shared them with us, and we just continue to feed them and grow them. This is my wish for you: comfort on difficult days, smiles when sadness intrudes, rainbows that follow the clouds, laughter always to kiss your lips, sunsets to warm your heart, hugs when your spirit sags, beauty for your eyes to see, friendships to brighten your being, faith so that you can believe, confidence for when you are in doubt, patience always to accept the truth, and to love your life completely. What if one day you come to the realization that you never again have to explain yourself to anyone, ever again, anymore, or that you no longer must carry the burden of another's false perception of you, or your own perceived inadequacies, and you can finally just relax, knowing you are incredible in the light you are standing in at this very moment. And what if you could go on to not care about judgment that somebody else might have? That your life is not full or amazing enough? Or that you no longer feel the need to endlessly apologize for just simply being human? That day has been graciously waiting for you to begin swimming in its warm waters of love and acceptance. That's from a book, Open Passages. Now this one was by Jeff Brown, and again, I just love this. Think of your triggers as ghosts from your exponential and ancestral history. They are ghosts who have not yet found their peace. They want to, for that's why they keep showing up. But they need your help. They need you to get in close and listen as you share their unresolved past with you. They need you to see them in just the same way you want to be seen. If you keep ignoring them, they're not going to go away. They will just keep showing up more often, and your life will become a kind of ghost-fulfilling prophecy, one where every choice you make will haunt your days. Perhaps it's time that we accepted that we are the haunted house that we fear. In each room, a ghost that is ready there to be liberated. In the basement, that unconscious that is ready to be revealed. Maybe we should give ourselves this gift instead of candy at Halloween. We just need to give ourselves permission to heal, for that is truly the sweetest gift of all. Sometimes I'm speaking from a little bit of experience, can you tell? A scientifically controlled study conducted by a German researcher at the University of Kassel has shown that while the chest area of an average person emits about 24 pounds of light per second, someone who meditates on their heart center and sends love and light to others emits an amazing 100,000 photons per second. That is 5,000 times more than the average human being. Numerous studies have also shown that when these photons are infused with a loving and healing intent, their frequency and vibration increases to the point where they can literally change matter, heal disease, and transform negative events. 10 minutes of meditating on compassion, on kindness for others, and you will see its effects all day. That's why it's very important to maintain a calm and joyous mind. This came from the Dalai Lama's book, The Book of Joy. Magic surely exists, for how can we doubt it, when there are rainbows and wildflowers, the music of the wind, and the silence of the stars. Anyone who has loved has been touched by magic. It is such a simple and extraordinary part of our life that we live. Nora Roberts. Now, shall I stop here? Does anybody want to come up and read one or share one that they have?
I have a couple, but can I do it for you?
Okay, sure.
Okay. Albert Einstein said, there are only two ways to live your life. One is as though nothing is a miracle. The other is as if everything is.
Beautiful.
Then Oprah Winfrey said, everyone's acting at the level they know. And when you know better, you do better.
You do better. Absolutely.
Eckhart Tolle said, and I think this is from his Power of Now, the book that he wrote, accept, then act. Whatever the present moment contains, accept it as you have chosen it. Always work with it, not against it. Make it your friend and ally, not your enemy. This will miraculously transform your whole life.
Thank you. Don't we have just a wonderful place that we live in? To have all these wonderful people to share these thoughts, to keep uplifting us and keeping us inspired, so that we can just keep moving forward with joy. And Julie, did you have one?
Oh, well, there's so many from the Course in Miracles, so I mean, it would be really, really tricky. I love the I rest in God. I am as God created me. I am sustained by the love of God. And there was another one. There's just so many. They're just, and I love the Course. It's just so comforting, the words. I try to do it like a daily reading. And it is so inspiring. As well as my 2.5-year-old grandson. He teaches me to be present, and I mean, what a gift.
What a gift.
Yeah, so that being present, I think it was Robert Holden that says, he's of course and a spiritual teacher, he says, every interruption of my schedule is my schedule. And I love remembering that instead of getting upset about it. It kind of helps me to reset and look at things a little differently.
You know, I've always hoped through this time that we all learned that it's time to let go and just be at peace. I've often heard that in my head lately of just be still and know that I'm God. And every time I say that to myself, I go, oh, that's right. What am I upset about? So here's the secret, darling. Things do not get better. They don't, but you do. You get better all the time. The world is always going to throw its left turns and spinning chaos at you. It's always going to try and tear things from your grasp, block your plans, make you stumble. But you are there to overcome all of that, to grow and to change and to blossom, to get stronger and wiser and more sure of yourself, to learn what you want and what you do not want, to learn what you will accept and what you will not accept. That's the real journey. That's the sweet soul of life. The conscious decision that if you cannot fight the wind, you will learn how to use it. It has to end, you know, the self-hatred, the collective shaming, the disdain for other, the emotional trauma, the buried pain, the displaced humans, the misplaced kindness, the repressed trauma, the fake positivity, the meaningless materialism, the forgotten heart. It has to begin, you know, the self-love, the collective healing, the love for other, the emotional release, the liberated pain, the welcomed humans, the perpetual kindness, the honored story, the authentic feeling, that meaningful purpose, that open heart. It is time. Jack Bowen. Oh, I thought this one was so lovely. What if we were transparent about our own failures? But not as some kind of performance vulnerability test, but as an invitation to collectively destigmatize the messy process of lifetime learning. Rachel Allah. My heart and my brain divorced a decade ago over who was to blame about being the person in charge of the big mess that I felt I had become. Eventually, they could not even be in the same room anymore together. Now, my heart and head share custody with me. I stay with my brain during the week and my heart on the weekends. They never speak to each other. Instead, they give me the same note to pass to each other, and it always says the same thing. This is all your fault. And on Sundays, my heart complains about how my head has let me down in the past. And on Wednesdays, my head lists all the times that my heart has screwed everything up. Lately, I've been spending a lot of time with my gut, who serves as my unofficial therapist. Most nights, I sneak out of the window in my ribcage and collapse on my gut's really plush leather chair. It's always open for me. And I just sit. And I just sit. And the sun comes up. Last evening, my gut asked me if I was having a hard time being caught between my head and my heart. I just nodded. My heart is always sad about something that happened yesterday, while my head is always worried about what's going to happen in the future. My gut just smiled and said, "Well, in that case, you should go stay with your lungs for a while. If you're exhausted about your heart's obsession with the fixed past, and your mind is focused on the uncertain future, your lungs are the perfect place to be. There's no yesterday in your lungs, and for that matter, there is no tomorrow either. There's only now. There's only inhale. There's only exhale. And there's only this moment. There's only breath, and in that breath, you can rest while your heart and your head work their relationship out without you." So this morning, I packed a little bag, and I walked to the door of my lungs, and before I could even knock, she opened the door, and she said, with just a gust of warm air, she embraced me and said, "What is taking you so long?" John Modell with that. Once we begin to celebrate what our body does, rather than obsessing on how it looks, we start to appreciate our body as an instrument rather than an ornament. Ashley Turner. People will come and go in life, but the person in the mirror will be there forever. So please be good to that person in the mirror. Music is the soul that can be heard by the universe. If dark nights must come, let them come. Open your doors. Let them come, my dear, and ask them what they want. Maybe all they want is your presence, nothing more. Maybe all they want to do is to hold you so close and polish you secretly without telling anyone. Maybe that's all they have ever wanted. Know that deep down inside they hold 10,000 fragrant mornings. They hold the source of laughter. They hold life. I would not know how to say this person's name. But here's Robert Holden. No amount of self-improvement can make up for a lack of self-acceptance. I really love that. I want to just keep holding that one close to my heart.
Repeat that, please.
No amount of self-improvement can ever make up for a lack of self-acceptance. Jean?
Well, I've got another one.
The other night I was watching Land. It's a film that Robin Wright did about, you know, grieving, and it's very interesting. It seems, you know, true. But she said to this gentleman who helped change her life that came by, and she was living alone in the mountains for a long time, and she said, "How did you happen to stop here? Why did you stop?" And he said to her, "You know, it was in my path." And I've thought about that so much. It was in my path, because when things come in our path, we can either choose to open ourselves to them or walk on or walk backwards. You know, and I like that a lot. It's in my path. In my path.
Yeah, and trusting that it was given to us for that reason, right? For us to open our arms and embrace it and welcome whatever it came to teach us. Absolutely. So there is no excuse. Don't tell me you are not inspired. There is no excuse. Creativity doesn't land, it is earned. So wrench your eyelids open, cackle at that keyboard, stomp your feet, force the words together. You feel like you're piling stone upon stone, making nothing but an ugly mountain of rock. But from the top of it, at the end of that sweaty hour, suddenly a staggering view, a gift of a story unravels for you, but not of you. Write fast, for creativity is not yours and you should never waste it. Samantha Reynolds. People will come and go in life, but the person in the mirror will be there forever. So be good to yourself. And while I'd already said that once, I felt it was certainly important enough to repeat. May you never forget how far you have come, for you have traveled miles to get to this place. May you never forget the starless nights that shaped you and gave you the hope and the strength that you needed to carry on. For after all the years you have made it through over and over, life has always found its way to you. And even though you still have a long way to go, all the miles you have traveled matter far more than you know. Morgan Harper Nichols. Well, thank you everyone for giving me this opportunity to prepare this, because it was so good for my soul. And of course, it's very lovely to be here with you sharing it. So thank you again. Namaste.
Inspiration for this song. We get our inspiration from a lot of places. For me, sometimes it's literature as an English teacher, sometimes it's stories, it's about family. This one comes from nature and from the person I co-wrote it with. Last summer, my family spent some time in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan in Marquette, and my 8-year-old daughter and I wrote a song together. And so this is called Swimming in Lake Superior. And Tony goes ahead and sing it because it's more from her perspective, my daughter's perspective, than mine.
I feel strong, not weary now.
song to celebrate inspiration. And I could, as you were singing it, I was just picturing you both, you and your daughter, Austin, swimming together. And also a beautiful song to celebrate Earth Day. So thank you for sharing that with us.
And I was glad you included the part about freezing. I was thinking, how would anyone live in the lake Superior?
I'm from the UP, and you have to be strong to go on Lake Superior. Ice cold.
She jumped in.
Eight-year-olds can do that.
Thank you. Thank you, Dick and Percival, for joining us today. We are loving you. Sharings and offerings. They really called up a lot of things for us. And you know, it is wonderful that all of us have the ability to have these things come to us all the time. And it's a good idea to break them down or keep them in a binder like that and go back and when we need to, you know, be inspired again. So good idea. Your wonderful way of sharing and joining us virtually. I hope that you all enjoyed it as well.
Yay.
And thanks to everyone who came today. Thank you for being here with us. And we're just going to keep rolling along and hoping that more people are showing up. So thank you for coming out and being with us. I do have a couple of announcements. Out on the table out in the lobby, there are some flyers about Taylor Swan's memorial that's coming up this Saturday, the 30th at 3 p.m., so all of the information is on that flyer. So I hope you will join us in that, too, in celebrating his life. And I also want to let everyone know that Nancy Bernthal's mother recently passed.
Oh.
And how old was she, Samantha?
101.
Yeah. And Nancy's been caring for her for so long, and she does. She's such a good daughter, and just really taking care of her mom in such a heartfelt way. I know that she would love to hear from you, whether it's a card or a call or a text or an email. And if you don't know how to get a hold of her, please just call the office and Samantha can guide you. And so we are going to join together in our peace circle as we call peace in.